Databutton lets you build AI apps that help you work 10 times faster and perform way better in your day-to-day. It's one of the few AI builders out there that helps you create internal apps that actually helps you perform better in work. Whether that's as an owner or as a marketing lead at your company, Databutton can help you create custom tools that you can use inside your own workflows. In this video, we're going to build a marketing dashboard with an AI churn detector to show you what's possible in Databutton. Thank you so much to Databutton for sponsoring this video. I'm so excited to show you what is possible when we build with Databutton. So here we are in the app builder. I've put our prompt in, which describes that we want to build a marketing dashboard with the churn detector. So we're going to hit continue. Here we can upload more information about the app, such as requirements, user stories. In our case, I'm going to skip this for now. We can always add more later. And then for design inspiration, I've just grabbed a really nice dashboard off of Dribbble, and we're going to use that as our design inspiration here. So let's get started. So here we are in our Databutton dashboard, and we have five tasks that Databutton created for us. It's already starting to work on the first task here. And then on the right side, you can see the agent is basically creating subtasks inside of each task and marking them off as it gets done. So that's something that's nice about Databutton, is that it is going to be thinking through what it's building as it does it. It's also going to help debug any issues automatically without you having to intervene. Now, what makes Databutton nice for businesses is its ability to integrate with other services. So one example of that is the OpenAI integration we're going to add in, but you could also add in other data sources. So in this app, we're using dummy data just to show what's possible, but you could build an integration with something like Mixpanel, with something like Google Analytics, to bring in your real business data into Databutton and then build apps around that. So we're going to mark the first task as done. And then what it should do is automatically start working on our second task. Now, what you always can do is type messages and have a human in the loop to look at what's happening. You can modify it. But in this case, we're just going to move on to the second task and continue building this out. You're going to want to stick around until task number four to build out the OpenAI connection, because I think that's going to be the coolest part of this build, is building in this additional functionality. The other thing that makes Databutton nice for using it in a business context is it's flexible enough for developers who understand all of the code and everything behind the code and the database and what's happening. But it's also easy enough to use for someone non-technical to build with it or get something started and then pass it off to someone more technical. Okay, so we finished that task as well with setting up the database schema. You can also go to users and data here at the top, and you can view and test this out. We have customers and daily metrics. This is just some dummy data. Again, you can integrate with your own marketing tools using Databutton and ask the AI to do that, to actually have your own data in here. But this is the dummy data here in the database, and it's really cool that Databutton can configure all of this for us. And if we go to the preview tab, here we can see the pages that it created already. We can see the components, UI files, APIs, libraries. So everything here is accessible. You can see both the preview and you can also edit the code directly. So we finished this third task, so we can complete that. And now we're moving on to what I am most excited about, is building the AI churn detector. And this is where we can really show off Databutton's capabilities of integrating with other services. So it's asking if I have an API key. So I'm gonna say, yes, I do have an API key for OpenAI. I'm curious, I think it should pop up here and ask me to enter it. Now I can go over to my other screen, go to my OpenAI account. And if you don't have an OpenAI account, you can create one for free. And then just go to the API keys tab, create a new secret key. And what I'm gonna do is just copy that in here. And this is basically like a password into your OpenAI account. That's how API keys work. So that way we can send messages to OpenAI and then get a response back. So I just saved it. And what also is nice about Databutton is it saves them securely. So it puts it into the secrets so that your key isn't going to get leaked. So let's go ahead and start the task. And what it's going to do now is start building out this AI functionality feature. I'm very curious to see what this ends up looking like. Okay, so it says it completed this step five. What I'm going to do is test this out. So I'm going to go to the preview tab on the top left. Databutton created this authentication component, so the ability to sign in to our app. So let's quickly create an account. And here I am inside of our dashboard. And we can see it's pulling in the dummy data. So it's showing us customers, MRR, things like that. So we have this in our dashboard. And then if we go over to the churn detector, and here we can see it looks like the AI detection is happening. We have this loading indicator. And in a second, we're going to see back what the AI model is saying. So it's been loading for a little while. What I'm going to do is send a screenshot of this to our agent and just ask it to verify if it's working. So this is where chatting with the agent can be really helpful. So what I'm asking is to add a button to start the churn detection, which I think is going to be helpful maybe in making this work, but also in helping us debug it if it's not running again. All right, so now it is fixed. Something that might help you if you're debugging is just to tell the AI to review all of the code involved, which can help it take a step back instead of just continuing to go down the same path that doesn't work. So this is very cool. Now we have a list of our customers with a churn risk score and also a reason of why. So this says very low NPS and short tenure, so just high churn risk. So a lot of it here is based on tenure and NPS, but of course, this is only going to get better as we would add more data into it. So we have this AI churn detector now working. So I hope that you enjoyed this video and are thinking about how you can use Databutton for your own business. I can already see how building these AI features on top of our data, like this churn detector or other features, are going to help bring much more power to this type of data than a spreadsheet or even other tools like Google Analytics. So you're going to be able to customize your analysis on top of what you already have. Leave a comment below to let me know if this is something that you would use in the future. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next video.